In this video, we'll do a demo on the Swahili transcription feature in ElevenLabs Scribe. So I'll show you how to easily auto-transcribe Swahili audio into text or subtitles using ElevenLabs Scribe. Welcome to this video. My name is David and I hope you're well wherever you are around the world. Now, depending on when you're watching this video, this particular feature may have been discontinued because it's available until the 9th of April 2025. At the time of recording this video, that is what it reads on ElevenLabs. That is to use it as an interface. For the others, you need to pay when you use the API and all that. But it supports up to 99 languages to automatically transcribe speech into text using ElevenLabs Scribe. Now, it mentions up to 99 languages. So I decided to do the following. I got an article on BBC Swahili. And it's this particular article on Russia and Ukraine on the talks that were held in Saudi Arabia. So this is in Swahili. So I went on into Audacity, did the recording, and you can listen. Urusi na Ukraine. Tunachojua kufikia sasa kuhusu mpango unaopendekezwa wa kusitisha mapigano. So it's more or less like the title that I've just read right here. So I now want to use ElevenLabs to see or demonstrate if it is good for this purpose. So as you can see in the free Swahili speech to text transcription, more or less, we're looking at the OpenAI Whisper in testing. That it means ElevenLabs beats OpenAI Whisper in testing with word error rates of just 10.2% on the Fleurs benchmark and 17.2% on the Common Voice benchmark. Industry-leading transcriptions for Swahili films, podcasts, business meetings, medical dictations, and more. So if you scroll down, you can see now the benchmarks here. So for Scribe 1, which is the ElevenLabs Scribe, it has this particular word error rate. DeepGram Nova 2, you can see the word error rate. Gemini Flash 2 has a 9.8 word error rate. Whisper Large version 3 has a 39.5 word error rate on that particular Swahili audio. So you can still incorporate this into your apps. Super, super awesome via API and all that. And also, obviously, if you come to this and just click on any language right there, it's going to take you to that particular language or interface for that. So let's go back to Swahili and go back up. And I already have my audio saved here for me to use. So I'm just going to click on go to app. And because I'm already logged in, I'm just going to access it. And you can sign up from the link in the description below. And I'm going to go to the speech to text feature here. And from here, I'll just click on transcribe files. It's free until April 9th. So I'll just drag and drop this right there. It's just a 1 minute and 15 seconds. So you can decide to let it know the primary language. I'm going to simplify it for this particular one so that we can actually have it not really think about it. We want to go for Swahili SW slightly here, Swahili. For the rest, I'll just leave it as to detect. You can tag audio events, especially laughter, footsteps, and so on and so forth. But I just click on upload files. So there we go. Swahili audio, it's processing. And more or less, these are all the other files I've actually worked on using this. And it's super, super good. So it's done with the Swahili audio. I'll just open it up here. So let's just listen. Urusi na Ukraine. Tunachojua kufikia sasa kuhusu mpango unaopendekezwa wa kusitisha mapigano. Wiki iliyopita nchini Saudi Arabia, wajumbe wa Ukraine na Marekani walikutana kujadili kukomesha vita nchini Ukraine. Baada ya saa kadhaa ndani ya chumba, walitangaza mapendekezo ya kusitisha mapigano kwa siku 30. Ilikuwa ni habari iliyokaribishwa sana huku viongozi wa Ulaya wakisifu mpango huo. Ukraine ilikuwa tayari kuacha kufyatua risasi na kuanza kuzungumza. Waziri wa mambo ya nje wa Marekani, Marco Rubio, alisema, "Na kama Urusi itakataa ofa hiyo, basi kwa bahati mbaya, tutajua ni kikwazo gani cha kuleta amani hapa." Kufuatia tangazo hilo, mjumbe wa Marekani, Steve Witkoff, alipeleka mpango wa kusitisha mapigano nchini Urusi ambako alikutana na Putin na maafisa wengine.
Hata hivyo, Urusi bado haijakubali, kwani Putin anasema kuna maelezo mengi yanayohitaji kufanyiwa kazi. Urusi iko tayari kusitisha mapigano, kiongozi huyo anasema, lakini kuna tofauti ndogo ndogo. Anasema ni lazima kuleta amani ya muda mrefu na kuondoa sababu kuu za mgogoro huu.
Now, the transcript is almost 100% accurate. And as we've seen, the word error rate, for example, here, Swahili is included in the more than 10% and under 25%. So it's good. I'll say it's good for that. The transcript is good. Maybe some slight punctuations here because some of the sections, for example, the title here had more of like a question here. And I think that should have been picked from my voice when I read this.
Urusi na Ukraine. Tunachojua kufikia sasa kuhusu mpango unaopendekezwa wa kusitisha mapigano.
So, more or less, but it got the text correct. The only one you should have separated a little bit is this ndogo ndogo. Should have separated it because those are two words, more or less, but I think it's one. And then maybe my English for Steve Witkoff. That was an issue. But other than that, everything else looks good. So if you have Swahili audio and you want to automatically transcribe the Swahili into text super, super fast and easily, ElevenLabs Scribe seems to be a good option to kind of use right now. It's free until April the 9th, so you can actually work on it. Do the best you can to kind of get your audios automatically transcribed right there. But as far as the quality goes, that is more or less the word error rates. Very few words have been missed. For example, Siku Thelathini, right here, it's 30 days, but you call it Thelathini. So it was really, really correct in what it actually did right there. So that's super, super awesome. And more or less, I wish, if I'm not mistaken, from what I've seen for the pricing, I think there should be somewhere here. So it's free. Scribe is free in the web app until April 9th and has the following price via API. Now, I wish they had more or less like a trial free, even if April 9th goes away, for people to actually test it out before they purchase and all that. But that is what I can say. It has done a really good job, and that is how you can easily and automatically transcribe Swahili audio to text or even subtitles, because you go to the export, you can do SRT, you can do text, PDF, JSON, HTML, and DOCX or DOC. Now, that's it for this video. I hope it's of value to you. Thanks for watching.